Like most other American cities, Pittsburgh had plenty of speakeasies during the Prohibition era. But even though alcohol has been legal since 1933, one of those speakeasies is making a comeback downtown.
When the folks at the historic Omni William Penn Hotel planned the next renovations, they climbed back into history.
Barrel after barrel of prized whiskeys destroyed by government agents.
Back to 1920, when federal agents cracked down on illegal distilleries and breweries during Prohibition. For 13 years, revelers had to secretly slide into speakeasies because booze was illegal. Welcome to the 2012 Omni William Penn's Speakeasy.
As you can see, it's a very small, intimate space. It's tucked away under the stairwell that leads into the hotel. You know, it's very discreet. They were always very discreet, the speakeasies of the day, so that they were undiscovered.
Visitors will be able to take a sip back in time.
The cocktails and so forth that we will serve here are, from that era of the 1920s. So we're serving cocktails such as Rob Roy's, Old Fashions. We even have absinthe, sours, a lot of those. And we've had a mixologist come in and help us with recipes that will keep this room true to its era.
So while this new room will open next week to mark the start of Prohibition,
the lid is off in many places, with the downfall of Prohibition being celebrated in real old-time hilarity.
The spirit of 1933 will be celebrated here too, 79 years after the end of Prohibition.
I think that's something that, you know, you can't get potentially anywhere else in Pittsburgh, so it's got its own little niche.
Taking you back in history tonight, despite the crackdown from the feds, 15,000 raids that led to the arrest of 18,000 people here in western Pennsylvania alone. Our region was known then as the wettest spot in the United States during those 13 years. Kind of difficult to shed that reputation just a little bit.
Right, just a little bit.
Just a little
Very
bit.
Cool stuff,
yeah.
though.